It's a small flame in your heart. Every one of you has it. It burns steadily. Nothing can put it out. It's the voice within, your intuition. If you listen closely, it knows everything you need to know. When you add in your intuition, the flame grows. Your life becomes magical. Let's turn it on now. Intuition Ignition with your host, Kristen White.
Hello, everyone. You're listening to Intuition Ignition, and I'm your host, Mystic in a Minivan, Kristen White. You know, the love never dies. Our loved ones who pass on, we miss them so terribly. We wonder, are they in pain? Are they suffering? Do they miss us? What's it like? We have so many questions about those that we love who go to the other side. Well, my guest today is a psychic medium and an author of many books, but her latest one answers this very question. It's called The Love Never Ends, Messages from the Other Side. And the author is Sunny Dawn Johnston. She's an internationally renowned psychic medium teacher, author, and motivational speaker. Now, she's also written several other books, including the best-selling Invoking the Archangel's 9-Step Process to Heal Your Body, Mind, and Soul, as well as No Mistakes, Living Your Purpose, and Find Me. So, Sunny, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Happy to be here.
Yeah, so let's talk about your new book. I mean, you have done hundreds of readings. What is the common message that you hear from so many departed loved ones?
You know, absolutely, without a doubt, is I am okay. You know, that's always what people are wanting to know. Are they okay? Are they in pain? And it's always, you know, I'm fine. It's you that's not, you know?
Absolutely.
The spirit world is a very peaceful experience, and people, I think, have such a fear around what's happened because of the one day that they died or the process of their death that they don't know how to let go of that.
Well, let's talk a little bit more about hearing these messages. Now, you're a medium. I'm also a medium. The show is Intuition Ignition. How difficult is it for people to actually hear from their own loved ones?
You know, I have kind of a different spin than most people do, and that is I really believe if you have a heart connection with your loved one, that you can connect with them, that you can see the signs and receive the messages. The problem is, I think, the grief, the pain, the anger, the sadness, those types of things, that energy gets in the way or blocks us from seeing that our loved ones are right there. So what I always tell people is if you have a heart connection with someone, you're a great medium to that person. It's just getting out of your own way, really, so that you can see the signs.
So let's talk about some of these other messages. So when you tune in to loved ones who've passed on, what do those messages sound like, or how do they come in to you?
You know, for me, and I love your title, Intuition Ignition, I think that's great, I love it, it really comes in through feeling. The majority of it comes in for me that way. And I think what happens for people is they are so unaware, we're so absent a lot of times in our day-to-day life that we miss those subtle messages, and they often start very subtly, and then they get a little bit stronger and a little bit stronger when we're not listening. So what I try to tell people is, this is the thing that I think is so important, is you cannot focus on your loved one's absence and experience their presence. You have to be present and focus on the presence of the energy, the spirit of who they were, and you will have that experience over and over and over again. But when you're so focused on the absence, you experience more absence.
So that's interesting. I mean, when you think about that, it's kind of ironic. I mean, they are absent, right? I mean, they're not
exactly
with us on the planet. And so we're missing them. We have a broken heart. We are really longing for their presence in our life. So to not focus on that and to focus on just connecting, is that path through forgiveness? Is that through being grateful for the time we had with them? I mean, what does that look like?
Well, I think that what it is it's recognizing that they're not gone. You know, they are absent in the physical sense, but it's almost like they're just in the other room, or, you know, I use the analogy a lot of times, they just moved to China and they speak a different language. And so you have to learn that language, but when you're so focused on the loss of them, then you can experience that spiritual aspect of them that's showing up and that's giving us the signs. And oftentimes it's through forgiveness, forgiving ourselves for what we did or didn't do, or forgiving them and having that healing. But I think it's also remembering that we are meant to be joyful. And I think that we have been taught so much around death that it is a sad, heavy, dense experience for almost everyone. And if we could start to look at and find a way to see it through a different set of eyes and look at what are the possibilities and what connections could I have with my loved one now that maybe I couldn't then, maybe I could have a different, deeper even relationship with them.
Absolutely. We're going to talk about that when we come right back. You're listening to Intuition Ignition, and I'm your host, the mystic in the minivan, Kristen White. When we come back, more with Sunny Dawn Johnston.
You are listening to Intuition Ignition with Kristen White. To learn more about Kristen White, you can visit her website at kristenwhite.net. Who is driving your life? Kids, husband, career. Maybe it's time to hand over the keys to your higher self. This is the best place to start a conversation with your intuition. Grab a copy of Kristen White's number one international best-selling book, Mystic in a Minivan, at intuitionpodcast.com. While you're there, get your free copy of 10 Tips to Ignite Your Intuition immediately. Again, that's intuitionpodcast.com. Thank you for listening to Intuition Ignition. Your intuition is just waiting to ignite. The first easy step is to subscribe to this podcast to receive new inspiration from our thought-provoking guests every couple of days. Visit intuitionpodcast.com to subscribe now. Again, that's intuitionpodcast.com.
And we're back, and you're listening to Intuition Ignition, and my guest today is Sunny Dawn Johnston. She is the author of a brand new book, The Love Never Ends, Messages from the Other Side. And I loved what you said before the break, that we can have maybe a different relationship with our loved one or a deeper connection, because so many people in this lifetime have possibly a troubled or tense relationship with a parent, or things just aren't so great, but that's not really how it is on the other side. Does that anger or resentment carry over?
Well, it doesn't carry over on a spiritual level, but it does carry over within us, because oftentimes those of us that are left behind, that actually even gets fueled more. And typically what I find is the guilt and the shame are what are really activated, of how maybe we didn't show up or how they didn't show up in their anger, and then how we process that. So it really is looking at, okay, what could I do to look at this from a different perspective? And I understand that that's not the normal way that most people are taught. Most people are taught when they die, they're gone, and that's the end. But as you and I and so many of us know, it really isn't. It's just learning how to keep our vibration higher, because the denser we are, the lower our vibration, the harder it is to connect with our loved ones, the harder it is to feel them and hear them and see them. But when our vibration is higher, when we have more joy, then we can really tune into their energy and their messages and their love and feel it, literally feel it. The problem is so many people feel guilty if they feel joy, because there's this conflict that they were brought up believing that if you've lost someone, then you shouldn't be happy. You know, so there's this inner conflict of, well, I shouldn't, you know, if I really loved them, then I should really be in sorrow and pain and miss them and not enjoy my life. And the spirit world, in my experience, I would imagine in yours too, Kristen, is, you know, go out there and live and explore and enjoy, because that's what we're here for.
Absolutely. You know, it's interesting, because I always say as well that intuition is really just a deeper form of listening.
Yeah.
So it's hard to listen when we have a lot of noise in our mind, when we have that internal chatter, or we're berating ourselves for guilt or feeling sad because our loved one's not there. But if we can clear that out and have an open space up there, literally an open mind, then we can listen better and hear these messages. And I think that it's also important for people to understand, and I've seen this as well, is that sometimes someone who's really close to us will leave right before we're getting ready to have a gigantic breakthrough in our own lives, because maybe they can support us better from the other side. Have you ever found that to be true?
Absolutely. I think that, and oftentimes their leaving is part of what opens us up to look at life and what we're doing in a different way that helps us actually have the expansion. And, you know, I think that people don't want to think about it that way, but the truth of the matter is a lot of the human relationships are not what we would want them to be. They're not the loving, kind, unconditional type of relationships. However, oftentimes when we lose this body, when we drop this body, we get back to who we really are, and we can be such a different support from the other side. And if we're willing to hear, those of us that are here are willing to receive that support, it can absolutely change our lives. I mean, that's how I got into this in the first place, was through the loss of someone that really opened me up to something that I'd been pushing against for 15 years.
Yeah, I want to hear more about that story. I mean, you were a stay-at-home mom for 10 years. You know, I was also a stay-at-home mom. And then through spiritual practice, my intuition opened up. And that's what this show is all about, is that you can remember your gifts. You can remember your ability to see beyond what we see in the physical world. I mean, how did that happen for you?
Well, for me, it really was, you know, I'd had this experience for so long, but I didn't want to be different, and I didn't want to be weird, and I didn't want to be, you know, the weird one on the block like I was when I was a kid. And so I pushed against it until I was 28. And at that age, my ex-mother-in-law passed away, and I was with her when she left her body, and I was the only one that was there. And it was such a transformative experience for me, because I felt her spirit move through me when she left. And after she passed, it was no longer an option. It was no longer an option to push against and to deny who I really was and my gifts. And I was literally pushed in a variety of different ways into stepping into who I really am. And I credit her and that experience that I had with moving me into a place of not having so much fear and recognizing that this is who you really are, and it's time to get with it, you know?
And what would you say to some of our listeners who have maybe had a sense or feel like they might be intuitive, but they just haven't quite claimed it yet?
You know, I think that it goes back to something you said earlier, and that is we got to quiet our mind enough to be able to tune into it, because we've got so many things going on in our, you know, personal life and our kids and our work and our house and all those things that we don't take the time to just be present and be quiet and focus. And I really think everybody has this gift at different levels, and it can, if it's just nurtured, it's like a muscle. If you just give it a little bit of attention, and it'll get stronger and stronger and stronger. And then what happens is it gets so exciting for people that it's like, oh my gosh, you know, like when you start going to the gym, and oh my gosh, look, I'm seeing the transformation, I'm seeing the changes, so I want to go more and more and more. And we have these amazing experiences, and our entire life changes. I mean, had you known me 20 years ago, you wouldn't even have a clue as to who I am today. There's not even a comparison.
You know, I absolutely agree with that. It's almost like you have a walk-in of your higher self. So we're going to take one more quick break, and then more with Sunny Dawn Johnston, who is just an incredible, inspiring author and spiritual teacher. We'll be right back in just a moment.
You are listening to Intuition Ignition with Kristen White. To learn more about Kristen White, you can visit her website at kristenwhite.net. Thank you for listening to Intuition Ignition. Your intuition is just waiting to ignite. The first easy step is to subscribe to this podcast to receive new inspiration from our thought-provoking guests every couple of days. Visit intuitionpodcast.com to subscribe now. Again, that's intuitionpodcast.com. Who is driving your life? Kids, husband, career. Maybe it's time to hand over the keys to your higher self. This is the best place to start a conversation with your intuition. Grab a copy of Kristen White's number one international best-selling book, Mystic in a Minivan, at intuitionpodcast.com. While you're there, get your free copy of 10 Tips to Ignite Your Intuition immediately. Again, that's intuitionpodcast.com.
All right, and you're listening to Intuition Ignition, and today we're talking about loved ones who've passed away and how we can connect to them. And my guest is Sunny Dawn Johnston. Sunny, you also work with the angelic realm. You work with other guides and master teachers. How does that unfold for you?
You know, well, I started at 13. I started having experiences with the angels, which is really what opened me up to this entire, you know, new world, which isn't a new world at all, but for me it was. And so my angels have always been a part of my life ever since I can remember. The problem was that I denied a lot of the gifts that they brought to me. You know, I didn't have a lot of self-love and self-esteem and value in me, and so I didn't feel like I deserved to receive that support and that guidance, which I think is why I pushed against it for so long. And I think a lot of people do that. And so for me, all of my support mostly comes through feeling. I'm a clairsentient person. I'm a real feeler. But my angels have come to me and literally saved my life at different times. And so I really have developed a relationship with them that I depend on daily. It's a constant conversation is the way I explain it, that I have with spirit, with my angels, with my guides, with my deceased loved ones that have passed. And you know, I have a lot of support on the other side, sometimes more there than here. And so it's really recognizing that and inviting, or, you know, my first book was invoking that energy, that support, that love in so that I can channel it in the ways that are for the highest good of all.
You know, I think it's important, that title, invoking, that you have to ask.
Yeah.
Because that's just the way it's set up, right?
So. Yeah. And I think that's part of the deservability and the recognition that I'm worth asking for. And so if we put that invitation out, you know, ask and it is given. You open yourself up and then you will receive. But if you sit there with your arms crossed, how is anything going to come to you?
Absolutely. You know, and another thing, too, that I think is interesting about intuition, my intuition opened up. I mean, I'd always had a sense of it, but I really claimed it when I was 40, about 38. And that, you know, it can come in, and that it doesn't just come in where all of a sudden before us we see a vision of someone in a white robe who's glowing, and then they start speaking to us in like the James Earl Jones voice. You know, it's not like that, okay? So it's really more about, what do these messages look like? How do they come in? I've often been inspired by seeing some words on the back of someone's car, or I hear a lyric in a song that just answers a question that I was thinking about. Do you find that with angelic messages, that they come through that way?
Well, I have all of those experiences. I love license plates. That's one of my big ones, too. You know, music on the radio. The big one for me is the subtle feelings in my body. It's the gut sense that, you know, I need to turn right here, or, you know, keep going if I'm driving, or it could be that, you know, let me just go check on my son's room, and there's, you know, the lights are going on and off, or the refrigerator's open, or just things like that. It's kind of that. It usually is very subtle to begin with, is what I find. But if you don't listen, then it gets louder and louder. And it's, you know, sometimes people need that spiritual 2x4 to get them, and then that's what causes them to go, oh, okay, that's intuition. It's not just coincidence or something weird that happened, because we're so used to making it logical and trying to analyze it and figure out why, instead of going, okay, that's a sign.
Yeah, it can go from a whisper to a megaphone if we're
yeah.
not paying attention.
Very quickly.
So, last, before we have to go, let's just talk about the book one more time, The Love Never Ends, Messages from the Other Side. When someone passes away, we wonder if they visit us. And I know this because recently, earlier this year, my stepfather, who had been in our family for almost 30 years, you know, he passed away, and I was with him in hospice. And it's interesting because I was talking to him as he was leaving and telling him that it was okay, you know, because he had had a struggle for a very, very long time. And I felt that energy also just release.
Yeah.
You know, he was adopted. He had a lot of questions about who his family was and was he loved and things like that. And I said to him as he was leaving, I said, you're going to finally have the answers to all of these questions mm-hmm. for yourself that you've always wondered about. And then there was this giant release. It's like you just feel it, you know.
And it's such a beautiful gift for those of us to get to be there as
right.
well, because it's just this absolute love energy that just moves through you
right
now.
Yes, absolutely. So a couple days later, you know, he had his memorial service, and we had a reception at our house. And the chair that he always sat in, I said, you know, I just feel like he's in that chair. Like I just could almost see the outline of him. And it was interesting because every time someone would sit in that chair, they'd get up really quickly.
Yep.
And this went on for, like, you know, the whole 4 hours. No one really sat there. And we didn't say don't sit there. You know, there wasn't a barricade, but they'd just pop right back up. I mean, talk to me a little bit about that.
Well, because I think everyone could have that sense. They just didn't understand the sense. See, you had the sense and could see kind of outline or had a little more understanding, but everyone else, they knew not to sit there. They just didn't know why they knew that. That's what's so cool about it. You know, I've had a lot of experiences like that, and one of the ones that comes to me was when my mother-in-law was transitioning, and I just climbed right in bed with her and was talking to her. She'd had a stroke, so she couldn't communicate. And I, same thing, I was telling her it's okay. I think oftentimes they need permission. They need to feel that permission to kind of release. But the TV kept going on and off, and the maintenance guy came in because we were in a retirement center. The maintenance guy came in, and he unplugged the cable, and the TV went on and off. And he stood there, and he's like, this isn't even possible. he unplugged the TV, and it went on and off. He's like, it's not even possible. I'm like, oh, yeah, it's possible, because that's how Spirit's getting our attention and just letting me know that she's just getting ready to pass, and she passed probably within 10 minutes. So signs like that are things that, we might just pass off and go, okay, well, there's power surge. But how is there a power surge when it's not plugged in?
Do you find that, because you work with the angels closely, are the angels there? Is there a presence in the room when
Absolutely.
We're leaving?
Absolutely, and it's so beautiful. That was what was such a sacred gift to me, was that this room that just her and I were in, and the maintenance man part of the time, was filled with light and was filled with the presence of angels, and I could see her family members, her parents who I'd never met, her sister who had passed a couple years earlier. It was like there was 50 people in a room where there was physically only two or three. And that was such a if you tune into the presence of that, it's such a gift, because then you can have the memory of the light instead of the memory of the pain.
Well, it really speaks to the truth that we're never alone. We're really never alone in this lifetime, and we're never really alone in the other side. And I don't really want to call it another lifetime. It's just another dimension.
Correct. Yeah.
So before we go, tell us a little bit. You're in Arizona. I know you have retreats and you've written several books. Tell us a little bit more about your work.
Well, I do sessions. I work one-on-one with people. I do a lot of personal retreats. I do group retreats in Sedona, which is a beautiful, magnificent place to spend a few days. And I do a lot of events all over the country. So I speak at, on a lot of different circuits and speak teaching about intuition, connecting with your loved ones, empowering your spiritual nature and speaking up and finding your spiritual voice, because for so long I kind of hid out, not wanting to be different or weird. So I find that I tend to attract a lot of people that are looking to find their own voice that way.
Why do you think it's so important today for us to embrace our intuition and to live that intuitive life?
Well, I think that it's time. Our intuition is our connection to spirit, and I think as we are growing and evolving and expanding, we are recognizing that we are not just a body. It's a mind-body-soul connection, and I think we need all three in order to live the fullest life we can, and we need to be connected to all three. When we're only focused on one of any of them, we're not having the complete experience that we came here to have. Integrating the spirit into the body, which so many of us were taught, okay, we're just a body.
That's right, and we really are truly so much more.
Yes.
Sunny Dawn Johnston, author of a brand new book, The Love Never Ends, Messages from the Other Side. Thank you so much for being here with me today.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely, loved it. And everybody else out there who's listening, you already know the answer to every question you would ever ask yourself, and that answer lies within your heart. So just listen to what your heart has to say to you. This is Intuition Ignition, and I'm the mystic in the minivan, Kristen White. I'll talk to you next time.
Thank you for listening to Intuition Ignition. Your intuition is just waiting to ignite. The first easy step is to subscribe to this podcast to receive new inspiration from our thought-provoking guests every couple of days. Visit intuitionpodcast.com to subscribe now. Again, that's intuitionpodcast.com. And we love to hear from you. Don't forget to leave your feedback and your 5-star reviews on iTunes for us. We read every comment and encourage you to share this show with your friends. Intuition Ignition is another positive production of Rare Gem Productions. Thanks for listening.